In the last episode of Miniseries for SolidWorks Beginners, we made my teacup, but we got stuck at the handle because we haven't learned how to work with the sweat brush, which is what we are going to learn in this episode. Okay, this episode is number 5, and if you're starting from this episode, please stop right now and go back and start from episode number 1, because this is not your usual YouTube tutorial. These series are only for serious SolidWorks beginners, and the most important element that I keep emphasizing on is sequence. So if you missed on any episode, you have no business being here. Link of the first episode can be found in the comments section of this video. I'm gonna pin it to the top of the comments, all right? Let's get started. Pay attention to what I'm teaching you, because after I taught you how to work with SweatBus, I have 2 sets of fun questions. It's like a pop quiz, okay? Let's get started. SweatBus, just like Extrude Bus, Revolve Bus, and all the other tools, is placed on the Features tab, and you can see it here. It's grayed out, but when we move our mouse cursor on top of it, there is an explanation. Sweeps a closed profile along an open or closed path to create a solid feature. You can use this option in the property manager, such as guide curves, profile orientation options, and twist to create a wide variety of shapes. All right, that was it. I hope you learned how to work with SweatBus, and we move on to something more complicated. Let's go to Loft. What it does is it takes a profile that is a closed sketch. You know what a closed sketch is, right? Closed sketch is a sketch that is closed. This is a closed sketch. We can highlight it to see it's closed. And if I create an opening in it like this, boom, boom. And now it's an open sketch. So it takes one closed sketch as a profile, and it would sweep it along another sketch. Get your facts right. You need 2 sets of sketches. You cannot draw it at once. You have to draw your first sketch, confirm it, rebuild it. We learned about rebuild, and then call it profile, and then go draw another sketch. There are some do's and don'ts about these 2 sketches that you need to use as your profile and path. First of all, you cannot draw them both at the same time. You need 2 sets of sketches, different ones. It means you draw your first sketch and like this, you rebuild it, and yet, and then you go draw your second sketch. That's rule number 1. Rule number 2, your profile and your path cannot be on the same plane. You need to have them on 2 different planes. Rule number 3, your path and sketch should be pierced or connected to each other. You cannot sweep a profile and to a path that is not connected, okay? So, having these 3 rules in mind, we're gonna go ahead and do something, and then we will review it as we do them, okay? You don't need to be worried, oh, what are the top golden rules? No. So, first of all, I'm gonna draw a circle. This is going to be my profile. I'm gonna rebuild it. Did you notice? I clicked here. You could press Ctrl B on your keyboard, Ctrl Q on your keyboard, or press here to rebuild it. Now that I have my sketch here, I'm gonna go select a different plane, because I said my profile and my path cannot be on the same plane. So since my profile is on the front plane, I'm gonna pick top plane, activate the sketch, and make it normal to my screen. If you don't know how to do that, you just press space on your keyboard, space bar, and then click on normal to. Ultimately, you can press Control plus 8 as it shows over here. Now, I can draw whatever path I want. Let's just draw something random using line. I'm gonna draw something straightforward, then go here, then go a little bit here, then go here, 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 and then end up here, and that's it. So, look, this is going to be my profile, this is going to be my path. Again, I'm gonna have to rebuild the sketch, Control B, Control Q, go to the Features tab. Now, this option is not grayed out anymore. Selecting it, I see I have 2 fields to fill. The profile, which is highlighted here, the circle, and the path, which is highlighted here. Ignore the rest for now. We will get to them. So in the first field, it says profile. If I move my mouse to the next one, it says path. So this is going to be my profile. I don't need to come and select the other one. Once I select my profile, it automatically jumps and gets ready for the path. So you can quickly select the first and the second. Now this is how the part will look like. When I sweep the circle along this path, this is going to be my volume, and at every broken point on my path, which is where the points are, you see we have a breakage, we have an angle in the component. So this is it. Just like any other feature, I can find it on my design tree over here, sweep number one, which is the default name SolidWorks is assigned to this feature. I'm gonna open its combo. I see two sets of sketches. One is the profile here, two is the path. So if I wanna change any, I can just select them, go to the edit sketch on the pop-up menu next to that selected sketch, edit it, and make it normal too. Look, I'm gonna completely change this one. I'm gonna pick polygon, draw a hexagon inside the circle, and then I'm gonna select the circle and press delete on my keyboard to get rid of it. Now this is going to be my new profile. I'm gonna rebuild the sketch, and this is my new result. Even though we just did this successfully, we just created an issue here, and I don't wanna get into this. We don't wanna diagnose this. This is for another video. Ignore this issue for now, and you don't wanna know what caused it just yet. Okay, so let's just open it again and go edit the path this time. Let's just drag this one a little bit here, and the preview adjusts itself, which is nice. And let's just make it like that. So this is going to be the new model, and you can see it's adjusted. Now this time I'm gonna edit the path and on purpose do something that causes some issue. Let's do it. I'm gonna drag it so much until the preview goes away. First of all, the preview is still there, but well, it's not gonna work because the profile is interlapping. We don't want to do this. So I'm going to click on this arrow. First of all, we just noticed if our path is overlapping or intersecting, we are not able to perform it. The preview goes away. Once the preview goes away, you know, clicking on rebuild wouldn't solve anything. You just get an error. If I bring it back, the preview appears. Now, this is it. Another thing, this still works, right? We get the preview and we click, we get the model. Now, if I may go back and edit my profile, you know what? I'm gonna rename these so you know which is which profile. Okay, now I'm gonna go edit my profile again. One left click on that, pop-up menu, edit sketch. I'm gonna make this considerably larger like this and rebuild this sketch. Now the whole thing disappears, and it's not even a minor error now. It's just a no-go. We don't get any results. Do you want to know why? So let me make my profile and my path appear. So this big hexagon is going to be my profile, and moving such a big profile that is covering the both ends of my path is absolutely impossible because the whole volume will be too intersecting that it just, SolidWorks cannot just find any solution for it. If I make it smaller, does it work? Still doesn't work. If I make it this much, then it works. So the problem is not only the intersecting profile on both ends, even though I make the profile smaller and it's not intersecting anymore, or let me just make sure that they are not intersecting, I still cannot get any result. And the other reason is because of the smallest angles on my path, which I can see here probably, and or smallest radiuses that I have on the path that doesn't allow this big profile to be swept along that path. So I keep making it smaller until the results appear. So this is still not working. It just worked. So this is probably one of the biggest versions of this profile that I can pull off on this path. If I change my path a little bit, maybe I can go for something bigger. So this is going to be my path. Let me make all the angles larger. And in this case, I'm gonna try to make my profile a little bit bigger. And it still works because the lowest or the smallest angle on the path is now increased. Therefore, the tolerance for the size of the profile is increased. Let me know if that makes sense. If it doesn't, put it in the comment section below. Now we're gonna do a quick recap of the definition of the swept boss. And then, as I said in the intro, I have prepared a quick fun quiz for you. And I want you to pay attention and see if you can get the answers right. So, swept boss requires one profile and one path, okay? And you want your profile to be swept along that path. There were three rules to pull it off. One, you need to draw your profile and your path in two separate sets of sketches. That is, you activate the sketch mode, you draw your profile, you rebuild your profile, that is, save and exit that sketch. You go and activate the sketch one more time, draw your path, and then rebuild it again. So you have two sets of sketches. That is rule number one. Rule number two, your two sets of sketches may not be on one single plane. They need to be on two separate planes. Rule number three, your sketch and your path need to be intersecting. All right, while this tool is very simple and easy, you can still make a lot of complicated stuff with it and save a lot of time. Now, it's time for that pop quiz that I have prepared for you. I want you to pay attention to the following models that I'm about to show you on the screen and tell me if they can be made, not if they are, because we just learned in the previous episode that there are more than one ways to do a model. So I'm not asking if they are made with the swept boss, because you cannot know that for sure. I'm asking if they can be made out of the swept boss. So I want you to look at all the models and count the number of models that you think can be made with the swept boss. So this is the first model. Can it be made with swept boss? Yes or no? Just use your fingers to keep count. This is model number two. Can swept boss be used to make this part? This is part number three. Yes or no? Can swept boss make this for you? This is number four. Possible or not? This is number five. This is model number six. This is model number seven. And this is model number eight. So, I just showed you eight different models. How many of them do you think can be made by swept boss? The correct answer is seven. Seven of those eight models can be made with swept boss, and only one cannot be, and that's the only one. The reason this one cannot be made with swept boss is that it has variable cross section all over it. And this one requires a different tool, a little bit more advanced, and that's Loft, but we will get to that later. Now the second part of the quiz, out of these seven models that I told you can be made using swept boss, how many do actually make sense to be made that way? If you think there are other or faster ways to create these, then swept boss is not the right move. If you don't know any other way, don't worry about it. I know you're beginners, but with the knowledge that I have given you, assuming you have only watched the first four episodes, I'm asking you based on that knowledge. Tell me, do you think it makes sense to use swept boss to make this model? How about this one? This is number four, this is number five, this is number six, this is number seven. So the answer is only four of them are actually perfect for swept boss, and the rest are a waste of time. this makes sense, this makes sense, this and this. But the rest can be made using other features that can save you many minutes at a time. So for example, this one, you're better off making it with Revolve Bus and not Sweat Bus. Same for this one, again, Revolve Bus. This one is the perfect case for extrude. You don't wanna use it, you don't wanna draw two sketches for something you can do with one. Okay, how many of these did you actually get right? Did you know 7 out of these 8 models can be made using Sweat Bus and only 4 of them make sense to do so? Put that in the comment section. I wanna know if you're serious about learning this, how many of you got that actually right?
Folks, the depth of details for each of these tools can make these videos hours long. And it's not only the knowledge of the tools that you need to master SolidWorks, you need to know when to use each tool. For example, we just learned Sweat Bus is the perfect tool to make the handle. But does this mean you can use Swept Bus to make a handle like this one? The answer, the short answer, I'm not gonna leave you guess it. The short answer is no, because the cross section of this handle changes as we go throughout, as we start from this point and go all the way down. So you need to know when to go for Swept Bus and when to go for the other tool. As a matter of fact, this one can be made using for the tools that you have already learned. You wanna bet? This can be done using only extrude bus and extrude cut, which is the ideal case here. Ow, you don't believe me? Check this out. So you know all the tools, but can you do this? Can you make a handle like this? The reason you cannot do this is because of tons of missing details that you need to learn, like the whens, the hows, and the whats. If you're serious about learning SolidWorks, cut in front of the line and do the following. Click on the link in the description below. Go and watch my webinar. First of all, what do we want to do by watching this webinar? We want to fix all the bad habits that you have built when working with SolidWorks. These bad habits can cause you many, many, many hours as you work with SolidWorks on and on and on. And we want to fix it. Once we fix that, I'll give you access, that is a username and password, to my mini course. And you can go and watch the videos. Those videos are sequential and way more in depth. You get all of that for free, by the way. So you fix your mistakes. There are 10 common mistakes that I want you to fix right there and then. Click on the link, go register and watch it, and I'll give you your mini course. Don't waste time. Don't forget to subscribe here either. I'm Aryan, and I'll see you in the next episode.